Yeah, sorry I'm late.
I am here.
My ship crashed a while ago. I had to hitchhike to get over to a shipyard, which conveniently, that was the shipyard where my buddy Dan works, so I was able to borrow a Falcon from him. Hey, what's up, people? If you are new, don't forget to hit that big shiny red subscribe button and click the bell notification. Let's get going! I hope you had a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Yes, I know, this is actually super late. We're in early February now. God damn it. And I also hope you had a happy Chinese New Year. But then again, no one in China is gonna see this video anyway, but, well, to those of you who celebrate it who don't live in China, happy Chinese New Year. You know, for a while, I was lamenting that we never got Brothers in Arms Battle of the Bulge. However, given the current state of Gearbox, it's probably a blessing in disguise. I had hoped to get this up on New Year's Day, but I had fallen way behind. Some of which may or may not have had to do with procrastination. Also, Jeff, my robot, who's also my editor, kept making changes to the script, so that is why I was not able to meet my target of getting this up in January. In this new year of 2022, I will try my best to get more content to you guys. Also, in recent weeks, I noticed a rather sizable jump in the number of people who are subscribed. Thank you for that, by the way.
Hey, welcome to the sandbox. You smell very clean.
Also, I just mentioned him, but meet Jeff. He's my robot. And like I said, he's also my script editor who helps me out with the scripts for these videos. He doesn't really talk much. Yeah, he's real quiet. About a few words. Also, before we get started, oh God, we still haven't started yet? Wait. Anyway, make this the video that you subscribe to. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. Also, yeah, I know, I'm super late to the game, but what exactly was the point in YouTube getting rid of the dislike bar? Why? They say it was for the mental health of small creators, but frankly, I don't buy it. At this point, I'm basically convinced this was done as damage control to the benefit of certain corporations and public figures. Anyway, that is my two cents on that matter. One of my resolutions going into this year of 2022 was to make more videos. There are a couple of video ideas I had, but I'm going to be honest, there's been a bit of procrastination. Also with also recently I started working a night shift, and those are not exactly great. But hey, what can you do? Also, remember how I said I came up with some ideas I'm holding on to, well, that I'm working on? Anyway, yeah. That was just a couple of weeks ago. Before that, I really didn't know what to make a video about. Yes, I was absolutely creatively bankrupt. Excuse me. All right, now let's get into the meat and potatoes. I have a question for you, viewer. Have you ever had stuff that you had to get done and then you put it off and start doing something else entirely to the point where you totally forget what it is that you were meant to be doing in the first place? Yeah, that was me with Dragon's Dogma. This game has basically taken over my life. On numerous occasions, I have stayed up into the AM hours playing it. I lose literally all sense of time when playing this game. It is a fun as fuck game. Also, there is another game that has been absorbing up my time. That game being Company of Heroes. Specifically, a mod for it called Blitzkrieg, which is fantastic, but doesn't really work for the single player campaigns. Like, I tried playing the Invasion of Normandy campaign with this mod, and I got through like halfway through the Omaha Beach mission, and the game crashed. Yeah, it, campaigns and Blitzkrieg don't mix. Much to my chagrin. But I will come back to Company of Heroes later. There is something else I want to talk about in this video, and that is the subject of Dragon's Dogma 2. The wave is pushing me into the... As far as I know, there has been zero official confirmation of a Dragon's Dogma 2. But hey, it's fun to speculate and, you know, brainstorm ideas about what could potentially be in this new game. In no particular order, I'll be giving a list of some ideas... that I thought up in a brain... Some ideas that I have been brainstorming recently. There have been some... alleged leaks, but as far as I know, this is all just rumor and nothing official. So once again, as far as I'm concerned, there has been no official confirmation for a Dragon's Dogma 2. Every night, I go to bed and wish and hope we get a Dragon's Dogma 2. Yesterday, I saw a shooting star and I wished, can we get a Dragon's Dogma 2? And it's occurred to me that I have said Dragon's Dogma 2 like 4 or 5 times in the last minute. Let's crack on! Without any more inane, off-topic rambling...
You lie!
Number 1. Online co-op. In the original game, you create your pawn, and then your friend can borrow your pawn, and vice versa, right? How about... in addition to that, in a potential sequel, you take your pawn and team up with your friend, and they bring their pawn, and you can go on various co-op exclusive quests. I think you can do something similar to that in Monster Hunter World. I'm not entirely sure. Or even just roaming around the world fighting monsters, bandits, and bosses with your buddies. Come on! Also, how about some new areas to explore? In the original game, we got to see Crancis and we got Bitter Black Isle, which is a fantastic addition to the game. I think I've already said this, but I don't know, so I'm just gonna say it now. Go buy Dragon's Dogma. It's so much fun. Definitely worth the price tag of $30. I don't know if it's backwards compatible for current gen consoles, but if you have a previous gen console, then you're fine. It's available on PS3, PS4, Xbox One, Xbox 360, Nintendo Switch, and on Steam. That's a lot of platforms. So if you got any one of those, then you're golden. Also, to all my fellow Steam players who are playing Dragon's Dogma on Steam, you could hire my pawn, Morgana. She's a fighter, level 182, I think. She's super tanky and she hits stuff super hard. Now, if I'm being totally honest, I haven't fought Damon yet, and there's a simple reason for that. Many of the rooms I'd have to go through in order to get to where he is, some of them have death, and I would rather just avoid death. I still get flashbacks to the first time I fought him. It was over long before it started. Second time, I avoided him, but he managed to kill my pawns. Third time, I just lift-stoned out of there. I'm like, I'm not dealing with this. No, well, screw that. Currently, as of the recording of this video, I have over 140 hours of playtime on Steam. A number even higher than the liters of German beer that I have consumed this month. Anheuser-Busch has brewing beer down to an art form. Doppel Munich is another beer that I really love, but I think that's from a different company. Hell, I don't fucking know. Wait, hold on a second. Where were we? What the fuck was I going on about? Oh, right. Oh, shit. Damn it. You're not supposed to swear on YouTube. Well, I'm not monetized, so... the hell with it. Oh, right, new areas to explore. I went off on a complete tangent there. I'm gonna get back on topic now. Right, new areas to explore. We see Grancis and Bitter Black Isle. Like, how about, we actually get to see Mercedes' homeland of Hearthstone? We only ever really hear about it, but we never get to see it, and where Julian is from. Whose name I'm drawing a total blank here. I don't remember where he's from. I remember that we hear about it in the game as well, but we never actually get to see it. It would be really interesting to get to explore these new areas and see the culture, the iconography, the architecture, and see how it differs from Grancis, namely Grand Sorin. Have I already said to go by Dragon's Dogma? Hold on. I cannot, and I mean I cannot, recommend this game enough. Don't forget to wishlist this great game. Personally, I missed the sale, because I was broke at the time.
No!
And by the time I could actually buy the game, it was no longer on sale.
Play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
So I had to pay the full $30. But you know what? I have absolutely no fucking regrets. The game is a quantum ton of fun. I swear, it'll be like 1,000 hours before I get tired of this game. Wait, no. Buy it at full price, you cheap bastards. If you love a game, buy it at full price. Cheap gamers are hurting developers by not buying at full price. Be better, you cheap entitled scrubs! That was sarcasm. Modern gaming journalism, everybody. You gotta love it. Literally everything I have in my Steam library is something that I bought on sale. Well, with the exception of like 3 games which were gifted to me by a friend, the only game I bought at full price was Dragon's Dogma, and once again, I have no regrets. The game is fantastic. I was being sarcastic, but I'm sure there's probably some jackoff at Kotaku, or The Gamer, or The Polygon who unironically said something like that. I remember there was a video from ItsAGundam about this I was watching the other day. The link to that video will be down in the description. Damn it! Get off my back, Jeff! Ooh, my last idea for a potential Dragon's Dogma 2. I swear, I have lost count of the number of times I've said Dragon's Dogma 2. Anyway, this last idea I've got is a more in-depth command system. In the original game, you give 3 rather basic commands that sometimes they're kind of slow to listen to. You can tell them to go, help, or come to you. How's about taking a cue from the Brothers in Arms franchise? I was thinking, when you order them to come to you, they stay within close proximity to you until ordered otherwise, making your safety be their top priority. Or, when you tell them to go, let's say you run into a group of enemies, like, I don't know, Saurians or bandits. Let's say 6 of them. You can issue like an attack order and highlight like 3 of them so that you can take out the other 3. You know, a division of labor. You know, like how in Brothers in Arms, for example, you have one team lay down suppressing fire, while you have another team fall in on you and stick it to you. I really think that an in-depth command system, like, you know, that we get in Brothers in Arms, would work well in Dragon's Dogma. To an extent. Okay, I know I said I was gonna talk about Company of Heroes, but that's gonna have to come in part 2. In part 2, I will give my hopes and expectations for Company of Heroes 3, and bring up some of my gripes with Company of Heroes 2. That I hope to God don't rear their ugly head in Company of Heroes 3. Alright, Artas out. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go take a nap, because I was up to like 2 a.m. re-recording and making a bunch of changes. Then, I'm gonna grab a beer and play some Battlefront 2. And I will see you in the next video.